That we're playing is Mozart, and this is the Haydn one was opus one, number one, but I'm not really sure that was his first, because they found a quartet in the 1930s that was now called Haydn's opus zero. So even as a quartet of firsts, this and Mozart, this is definitely his first quartet, and he wrote this when he was 14 years old, God bless him. And he finished it when he was like 15 or so, 16. And so you can see the structure of the Haydn was like a little bit pre what we know of string quartets these days. As string quartets evolved, they became more like symphonies, where you would have an exposition. It's not allegro form in the first movement, and then a slow movement, and then a light movement, scherzo or minuet trio, and then a presto at the end. So Haydn in that one, he did presto and presto in the beginning and the end, and they sort of turned it topsy-turvy. So Mozart hasn't reached that point in the line of string quartets where he was doing the traditional string quartet as we know it. So because he's starting with an adagio, which is very slow, and then he goes into an allegro, and then minuet, and then a rondo. Rondo is another traditional last movement, and that repeats the melody. It comes up several times. So this is 14-year-old Wolfie Amadeus Mozart.
Thank you.
So in the second movement of the Mozart, you heard what's called a fugue, which is where one instrument starts, and then the next instrument comes in, and they kind of pass off the phrase, that musical phrase, and then it gets passing around, and then it gets like into a washing machine kind of thing. So then it finally comes back together.